LaMarcus kind of pushed him off, and I was like, whoa. And first of all, the crowd was hype. The crowd loved it.
We're back at the AT&T Center after the Spurs and Toronto game. Spurs winning 101-97. And it was pretty much tied up the whole time, right?
Yeah, I want to say 18 lead changes somewhere in the second half. Great game. I know Pop talked about the fact that this is their first time they were really tested physically. Toronto really got into them. So they had 20-plus turnovers, which is un-Spur-like. But 20 turnovers, you still get a win, but you killed them on the boards. But very entertaining game for this early in the season.
Fourth quarter got really, really intense.
Yeah, it was a fourth quarter. Ibaka and LaMarcus got tangled up there. Ibaka kind of shot an elbow. LaMarcus didn't take too kindly to it. They exchanged some not so friendly words. I'm a good lip reader. And they got nose to nose, and LaMarcus kind of pushed him off. And I was like, whoa. And first of all, the crowd was hype. The crowd loved it because, you know, that's been his knock from Spur fan and from the media. Like, oh, he's not tough enough. He's so to see that. And then after that, it energized the Spurs. I think they want to see that from LaMarcus.
Less than 2 minutes left of the game, he made a floating jump shot.
Yeah.
And then he got the and one. And did you see, like, a standing ovation from the fans?
That's what I'm saying. I mean, everybody's kind of waiting for that. Like, but I think they want to see that next Thursday night against the Golden State Warriors, against the champs. They want to see that in the playoffs. They want to see that on the road. But it's always been there. Again, LaMarcus is a great basketball player. Always has been.
Yeah, he got standing ovation. And as he was walking back to the bench, like, Pop met him out, like, almost halfway out in the court to just spank LaMarcus Aldridge.
I asked Dejounte Murray about it. I said, what'd you tell LaMarcus? Because Dejounte had put his arm around and said, hey, what'd you tell him? I asked him that just now down in the locker room. He said, I told him, hey, you're above that. Don't even worry about that kind of stuff. And to hear that coming from a 21-year-old kid.
Wow.
Yeah, exactly. So he's growing up on the job.
Speaking of Dejounte Murray, 16 points, 15 rebounds. You asked Coach Pop about that.
Yeah, I said, hey, Pop, have you ever had a point guard get that many rebounds? And he looked at me and laughed, and he said, I think Tony got that 8 years ago.
One of the lowlights, I guess, Joffrey LaVerne, who was heating up right before he got hurt.
Yeah, he was. You know, and I just saw him in the locker room as well. He's in pain. He was in pain. Like, he was just putting on his sock. You could hear him because Manu? Yeah, Manu came out, and you could hear LaVerne in the background like, ah. And I look over there, and he's putting on his sock. So he's, I don't know if he's going to be out. You know, I know they play again Wednesday against the Miami Heat.
Even coming off the court, like where we sit, where we got a good shot of them walking into the locker room, and he was in pain. His face was
straight. Normally you go to the bench, and you've told an athlete, tighten it up and see if you can go. He didn't even try to tighten up the shoe. He went straight to the locker room, and again, like I said, I was back there, and I heard him grimacing in pain. So.
And they did confirm that it was a sprained.
Sprained ankle.
Ankle.
That's the paper. I want to say right.
Right? Okay. Sprained ankle.
Yeah, sprained ankle. One of them.
One.
We only get two.
50-50 chance.
So I got a 50-50 chance. Exactly.
Sprained right ankle.
See?
You were right. Congrats, Rudy. I know there was a video circulating after the Spurs road game with Kawhi walking up to the plane. And I saw the video that you posted.
You saw that?
So the video we're talking about, we'll post it. But he's kind of like slowly walking up the stairs, and Spurs fans were like, oh no. Like, that looks bad. I did too.
Did you freak out?
I freaked out. But you posted a video today.
Because I saw
we should share
it. First of all, I didn't even know he was here. And then there was the timeout, and I'm like, wait a minute. I know those cornrows. That's Kawhi Leonard. And I say, you know what? I'm going to pull my phone out, zoom, because it's not like we're courtside.
Yeah.
So I was like, let me zoom in my camera, and I'm going to catch him walking. I want to know if he was just playing a little mind games with us. So I sat there, and I waited, and I waited. And finally, he starts walking. I'm like, that doesn't look, he's fine. He's a lot better than what we saw in that video of him walking. I think it was like a tarmac thingy getting on the airplane.
Yeah.
It looked bad. But tonight, I was like, okay, let me try to ease San Antonio Spurs fans' mind and post this video to Facebook to show, look, he's walking fine tonight. But what, the next time you see us would be next Thursday.
Next Thursday.
Golden State.
Big game.
Big game. I mean, they only play four times. I don't know if Kawhi will be back, but, you know, of course, I don't want to dismiss the four road games, but only thing people care about is when they're going to see us again. They won't see us again until next
Thursday. Yeah, they really care about that.
They won't see us again until next Thursday night.
Yeah,
so.
This is only home games.
But no,
we're not
Heat, Magic, Pacers, Celtics, then Golden State. Good test, good little stretch run for the Spurs, and Pop loves on these. He loves these little road trips.
Spurs now 3-0 on the regular season.
Wow.
That's it from the AT&T Center, 101-97.
See ya.
Peace.
Peace.
Yeah, that's your
peace.
Thing.
I'm sorry.
That's your thing. Peace.